Well, hello and welcome to the LifePoint Weekly Devotional. My name is Josh and I'm one of the pastors here at LifePoint. I say weekly because we are now restructuring the formatting of our devotionals to be once a week on Thursday, have a dedicated time to get in the Word together. And we're actually anchoring our content within the Bible Engagement Project itself. We'll be taking you through one of the weekly devotionals or daily devotionals you get to go through throughout the weeks. After we preach our sermons on Sunday, we come through and within the app itself, you can do a personal devotional. And I'd like to take a look at day three of this past week. We are in volume two, session one. And I think it's incredible to read. And there's a passage in Hebrews that it ties off on as we look at the story of Abraham and Isaac. And this is what it says in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 17. It says, "By faith Abraham, when God tested him, offered Isaac as a sacrifice. He who had received the promises was about to sacrifice his one and only son. And even though God had said to him, 'It is through your son, Isaac, that your offspring will be reckoned,' Abraham reasoned that God could raise the dead, and figuratively speaking, he did receive Isaac back from death." There's some really important things throughout this story of Abraham and Isaac that we got to hit on Sunday. We got to hit on Wednesday with our youth and Sunday mornings with our kids as well. About this story, there's this thing of obedience. There's this thing of having faith in God, despite the absurdity of the situation. My youth students did not take it lightly that Abraham was about to participate in a child sacrifice. They thought the thing was absurd. They thought the story and the circumstances was absurd, especially going through Genesis, at the beginning of Genesis, and seeing how good God has been and how amazingly he has provided for his people. You see this story of Abraham getting this blessing that was 24 years in the making. And then God commands him to take the very blessing that he had been given and to sacrifice it. And Abraham, without any sort of complaining as he used to do, any sort of going behind his back as he used to do, he just chooses to obey and trust in God, even though it was said before that Isaac was going to be the son who all of the ancestry would be linked to. So it doesn't make a whole lot of sense. It also says in that story in Genesis 22 that Abraham took 3 days to travel. You could get in your head in 3 days. You could be able to look at the situation and say, you know, God promised me this, or God is asking me to do this, and both seem to be contradictory. And we can use our own human reasoning to say, there's no way that God is really asking me to do this. There's no way that God really wants me to step out in this way. Now, we at LifePoint don't condone child sacrifices. Please don't do that. But at the same time, God can ask us to do some really incredible and bizarre things. He can ask us to do things that seem out of the ordinary or seem contradictory or seem against who we are personally. And a lot of times that's because our human reason, our own humanity can get in the way and say, well, I'm not qualified to do this, or I don't have the purpose to do this. I don't have the motivation to do this. A lot of times we can get in our own head and begin to disqualify ourselves or take ourselves out of the game for what God is calling us to do. But what is so cool about this story, and it's reiterated here in Hebrews, is it says in verse 19, he reasoned that God could raise the dead, and figuratively speaking, he did receive Isaac back from the dead. You see, even as he was walking to go sacrifice his son, even though it made no sense and it was probably easy for him to say, there's no way that I'm really supposed to be doing this, he still had enough trust and faith in God to say, you know what? I still believe that even if I do have to sacrifice my son, God said And God promised me that my son would be who my ancestors are coming from. And so he reasons that God's gonna raise him from the dead anyway, because he had already promised that. You see, that's incredible faith, to get outside of human reason, to get outside of human logic and say, you know what? This situation doesn't make any sense, but God, I'm gonna follow you in every single thing that I do. The stuff that makes sense, the stuff that doesn't make sense, Lord, if it's from you, I will follow and I will do it. And man, I think in these times especially, there is something in obedience and something in faith that God can really move and work in. We see that. Abraham gets his blessing after the fact of proving himself to be obedient and faithful to the Father. That's when he gets this blessing of having ancestors as countless as the stars. And I think that it's really awesome to see the way that the New Testament references the Old Testament. And there's so much packed in this book from beginning to end that just weaves itself together in a really beautiful way. There's countless other devotionals like this that you can go through each and every day. There's about five a week that you can go through and then review some. And then we kick off each and every volume section with a sermon on Sunday mornings, so that you can hear the word on a Sunday like you would any other Sunday. And then you can actually engage with that same text and that same topic throughout the week and be able to see how it's woven in Scripture. I just think that there's something incredible about God's Word, and I hope that if you haven't downloaded the Bible Engagement app, that you would do that. It's on the Google Play Store. It's on the App Store. You can do that. Sign up through Faith Life. Make sure that you get on our group, and then you connect with us that way, because this is what we are going through. We are in volume 2 now, and just really, really excited to see how God continues to speak through his word that is completely tied together and woven together. New Testament, Old Testament, it doesn't really matter. I think that that's incredible. Have a great rest of your week, LifePoint. We'll see you on Sunday. Make sure to come to one of our services at 9 a.m. or 11 a.m. Or check us out online, because we live stream our services, and we are so thankful to have that opportunity. Thank you, and have a great, blessed rest of your week.